Hello and welcome. In this video, we will discover 9 mind tricks used only by bad boys. Ever wondered what it is about bad boys that makes them so attractive and desirable? The typical bad boy is really just an archetype, which is an easy way to describe a certain type of guy. Many guys try out the bad boy archetype with great success, and by doing so, they are able to harness their strengths, get more attention from the ladies, and unleash a level of attractiveness they never knew was possible. Let's find out these 9 mind tricks used only by bad boys. But just before, make sure you subscribe to the channel and don't forget to download your free book to successfully seduce any girl by clicking on the link in the description below the video. 1. Don't smile constantly and stop obsessively nodding your head. When listening to someone, people who are too nice are guys that girls do not find attractive, and one of the main things they always do is nod their head up and down when somebody is talking to them. Studies have shown that girls find men far more attractive when they smile less and when they appear more tough and intimidating. When you excessively nod your head, you are projecting a giant bat signal up into the sky. Instead of the bat logo, it's a giant text that says, "I'm needy." What is the number one thing that girls look for in men? The answer is protection, and who better to protect them than a guy who looks tough and intimidating? So when talking to people, especially girls, smile less and stop excessively nodding your head up and down. This will make you look far tougher and far more intimidating. 2. Talk less. Growing up, we are always taught to talk more. One of the most powerful parts of the bad boy archetype is simply how little he talks. Silence is powerful, and silence is one of the easiest ways to trigger attraction with any girl. The reason for this is that silence is mysterious. Whenever you talk less, you make it harder for people to get a read on you through your voice tone and the things that you say. Many who have mastered the bad boy archetype talk less than other men and are able to say what they want to say in the fewest amount of words. Keep in mind that if you choose to talk less, you have to appear confident during the whole time that you're doing this. Otherwise, you'll just come off as creepy and weird. A lot of guys unintentionally screw this up, and they say nothing at all and look really unconfident when they do speak. This causes them to just end up looking weird. Therefore, if you choose to do this, it is a delicate balance that you need to practice to get the hang of. 3. The long pause. One of the most incredible parts of the bad boy archetype is the long pause, and when used effectively, it can make everything you say far more mysterious and far more powerful. Every interaction between humans is a complex dance of body language, voice, tonality, eye contact, and many other things. The sum of all these parts is what determines what people think about us. Now, the long pause is a huge part of the bad boy's arsenal, and it can have a profound impact on the way people feel around you. Now, to use the long pause, simply stare at a person for about 1 full second before you speak. When you are talking to them, making eye contact and then waiting a full second before you actually say something can make the other person feel slightly uncomfortable. But what you have to remember here is that the goal is not to make the person feel comfortable, but rather to make them feel attracted to you. Girls are biologically programmed from birth to feel attracted to men who are intimidating and dangerous. The reason why is because men who are intimidating and men who are viewed as dangerous are far more likely to be able to protect the girl. Now, what the long pause does is play on this primal trigger and make you appear more intimidating, thus more attractive the moment that you stop worrying about it. Whether or not people are comfortable around you is the moment that you will become 100 times more attractive, pausing and waiting for a full second before each time that you speak makes you come off as dangerous and mysterious. This is precisely what girls find very attractive, but when you're doing this, make sure that you keep a somewhat serious or focused facial expression. Otherwise, you're just going to come off as weird. 4. Don't get too excited. If you're trying to pull off the bad boy archetype, this is exactly what you don't want to do. Emotions are one of the tools that we use as humans to get a read on other humans and to be able to figure them out. So when you display less emotions, you become much harder to figure out. One of the hallmarks of the bad boy is mystery, and girls absolutely love it when they try to figure a guy out and they can't seem to do it. The truth is that any way you spin it, girls are very similar to cats, which means they are incredibly curious and they want to find out what's inside your box, so to speak. And by not getting too excited or displaying strong emotions, you become incredibly mysterious, and the more the girls cannot get a read on you, the more mysterious you will become, and the more the girls cannot get a read on you, the more mysterious you will become, and the more they will be attracted to you. Now, one of the easiest ways to get fully into the zone for this mentally is to think of yourself almost like a secret agent. 5. Be tougher. One of the greatest myths that men believe is that you must have big muscles and many tattoos to appear tough. In the real world, this couldn't be further from the truth. What mental toughness is actually a state of mind. Whenever I say tough, I mean mental toughness rather than physical toughness. Although having a decent amount of muscle does make it slightly easier to pull this off. Your typical bad boy without toughness is like James Bond without getting the girl at the end. You can't really play the bad boy archetype without mental toughness. Being tough is just a matter of not showing mental weakness. The bad boy archetype is not afraid to take risks, and you could easily describe him as brave. Being physically strong definitely helps you to convince other people of the role you're playing, but it's absolutely not mandatory. One of the easiest ways to show mental toughness is to say things to a girl without worrying about how she will react to them. Most people think about risk-taking in the form of like a giant jump on a dirt bike or jumping out of an airplane, and it's true that these are forms of risk-taking, but they're not really important for attraction. The most attractive form of risk-taking occurs when you're interacting with a girl. Simply walking up to a girl and talking to her is a form of risk-taking and mental toughness because it shows that, then asking her a ton of questions is another way to do it. The most effective form of risk-taking by far for the bad boy archetype is simply not being afraid to say what's on your mind. Whenever you show a girl that you can say anything to her and not be worried about what she is going to say back to you or how she's going to react to it, even if it's in a negative way, this is one of the most powerful displays of mental toughness that you can show. The reality is that most men are far too scared to do this, so when you do this, you're really going to stand out. Most men are too scared of rejection or too scared of what other people will think of them to say whatever it is they feel like saying. Now, before you go out there and try the bad boy archetype, you have to realize that it's most effective for short-term attraction. Playing the bad boy is not going to make you a ton of friends, but it will make you more attractive, and you might even find that your personality is actually a great fit for this archetype. And if that's the case, these simple changes might actually become a powerful part of who you are going forward. For many guys, the difference between being incredibly attractive or incredibly unattractive is nothing more than a few simple changes to their behavior, and borrowing some of the aspects of the bad boy archetype for yourself might actually be the smartest, most effective thing you have ever done in your life for your attractiveness. 6. Displays an unshakable confidence. This is possibly the number one most important quality that is a turn-on for all women when it comes to men: confidence. Not head games, not lack of interest, or even being a catch on paper. No matter what he looks like or how he dresses, a man with confidence does not need validation from anyone but himself. He is self-assured and will not yield to anyone else's expectations but his own. He is comfortable in his own skin, and though he might have a few insecurities just like any other human being, he doesn't let it get the best of him. No matter how hard life gets for him, he won't let it sink his self-esteem. In a nutshell, a confident man is not only a turn-on, but it rubs off on us when we get involved. 7. He pays more attention to your friend to make you jealous. This trick is often used when it's just you and one other girl out to happy hour. Guys rarely use this if they see you are with a big group of women because then it just becomes too much work to entertain them all at the same time. Here is the guy's perspective. He sees two girls, one that he fancies more than the other. Naturally, he will want to start hitting on your lesser attractive friend and then work his way up to you. The idea is that you are a bit offended, but your sense of competition will kick in and you will try harder to vie for his attention since you will see that he is already giving it not only to someone else, but someone that you are close with. 8. He doesn't text you back right away just to test you. Texting is the main means of communication nowadays, and it has taken strong precedence over the good old days of actually picking up the phone to have a real conversation with someone. For better or for worse, you have to rely on texting not only as a way of communicating with friends and family, but the courtship process of engaging in a potential romantic interest. Just like the art of time restraint, texting is a game of time. There are certain emojis you could analyze to decipher how he feels about you, but really you're overanalyzing, or you can keep track on how consistent he is. If you text him and he takes too long to text back, he might be thinking about what he is trying to say to you. Or, if he even forgets to text you back, it could be that he just doesn't care enough to communicate properly. Worst case scenario, he wants to keep you in the dark to heighten your attraction towards him. 9. Better at eye contact. Confident, self-assured bad boys are able to maintain that eye contact when they see somebody checking them out or looking at them. Because that's what happens when you're confident. When bad boys check you out, they'll hold it, maybe even give a little smirk. They don't look away instantly, they hold it. If you learn to hold it, this is going to send the subliminal message to the chick checking you out that you are the man. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, comment, and especially subscribe to the channel. You're also free to receive the new book, 9 Keys to Seduce Any Girl, by clicking on the link in the description below.